nothing that I chose. I kind of did choose it, but it's almost like it chose me. It's like, all right, this is what my direction is going towards. So this is what I'm gonna strive to do. I'm gonna try to be the best baseball player I can be. My best pitch is my fastball. That's what I said. I kind of throw hard a little bit on sometimes. So, I mean, fastball is my best pitch. I like the fastball. But you got to be able to throw your other pitches too. Because in the league, no matter how hard you throw, you can throw 100 and they can hit it out there to that infinity sign right there. Them boys are strong too. You got to do a lot. First of all, you got to get in the gym. A lot of people think it's your arm too, but a lot of pitchers, they got strong legs, they got abs, they in the abs, they got a strong core. But I mean, you can throw long toss, you got to do a lot of shoulder exercise. You got to have your shoulders strong. You see a lot of pitchers too have strong backs, just because it's a whole bunch of throwing, it's a whole bunch of twerk. So I mean, you got to hit the gym though. You got to hit the gym and you get out here in long toss and get your arm strong and get it conditioned and get that shoulder right. So it's a lot of shoulder exercises they have us doing. My first game in Major League was on my 20th birthday in Arizona in 2003. I just had 20 that day, and that was the day that I was making my Major League debut.
Nice birthday gift.
I know, right?
So where do you go up? Because Roger TV, they normally get my arms coming from the because of the South, they normally like ripping your chair.
They said the strong arms normally come from the north. Maybe. If you ask me, it just depends on your God-given ability. Some people is going to throw hard, some people not going to throw hard. The only thing you can do is work to get the hard you're going to throw, and then you deal with it. You got some people that don't throw hard, but they go and they play a whole bunch of years in the league because they know how to get people out. They know how to pitch. Was I scared? No, I wasn't really scared. It's one of them things, you probably be more nervous. I'm more nervous when I watch games from the bench than when I'm playing. Because I feel like on the bench, I can't do nothing about it. But in the game, I'm in control, so I got no time to be really scared. Once you start playing, once you're in the midst of the game, you know, your mind frame take over. You got to go out and you got to try to be a beast. And you got to think when you're on the field, there's nobody on the field that's better than you. Even if they are, but that's just the way you got to think. You got to think you're the best on the court. On the field, wherever you play. I mean, it feel good. I tell you what, look around here and think of all these seats having somebody in it, and then they watching you. All them people watching one person, because you on the mound, they can't play till you throw it. So you got 35, 40,000 people watching one person. You think you'll be nervous? See, there you go.
High school.
I'm from Georgia. So I was drafted in Georgia back in 2001.
And when I explained them, so in 2001 you got drafted from where in high school, then you played 8 years in the minors.
Okay.
And then
my little history. My history. I graduated 2001. See, that's where it started. So you got to graduate first. That's the most important thing I'm gonna say. And before I start the whole car, I graduated in 2001.
Everybody hear that?
I graduated in 2001. That started the whole career. I graduated 2001 to the Dodgers. I was with the Dodgers from 2001 to 2005. And after I was drafted, I went to rookie ball for a year. And then I skipped A ball, and then I went to Double A. And then I went from Double A to the big leagues. But then in 2006, I was traded to Tampa Bay. And I was there for 3 years. And then I went from Tampa Bay to Detroit for last year. Then after last year, I was in Arizona this year. And then I came from Arizona to here. And this is the best city, right?
Yeah.
Southside Chicago, right? Southside
Chicago.
Chicago always been one of my favorite cities. You know, Chicago always been one of my favorite cities. Good food, good people, good baseball. I'm good.
I'm good.
Yeah.
Three more questions.
No, you gotta go out there and try to be a beast in every game. Do I prepare differently for the postseason than the regular season? You gotta prepare. I don't change the way my approach, because you gotta keep the same mind frame every game. You gotta get through the regular season before you get to the postseason. And once you get to the postseason, you don't want to do nothing no different because you don't want to go try to do too much. You want to stay in the same tempo. You want to do the same amount, the same routine, the same program. But that's why I say when you're on the field, you got to have that mentality like there's nobody better than you. When I'm on the mound, even if they might hit it to the infinity, I'm thinking to myself, this dude can't touch me. Just because you got to trick yourself, you got to feel like you're the best person on the field. That if you at the back, you got to feel like that dude ain't going to get you out. Because if you go out there with that attitude, he see it, trust me. And if you go out there with that attitude like, man, he might get me out here, they see that too. So you feed off each other. You really got to go out there and you got to feel like you're the best person on that field that day, even if you're not.
Okay, now my last two questions, I want you to speak up like you're a lady friend on the side of the room so I can hear you, okay? That's how you called your girls on the other side of the room.
He
might.
He got that Barry White. That's mine. In the World Series. The World Series is one of them things, man. It can chill bumps to you when you're on the field. It's loud. It's super loud. And you got the whole world watching you. It's not only 40,000 people. You got the whole world watching you. That's the only baseball on TV at that time. So you got everybody around the nation watching you in that one game. And I mean, that's a feeling. That's a feeling that you can't explain, but it's a great feeling when you get to the World Series and you got everybody watching you.